Hey, what's up, YouTube? Very rarely do my multiple interests kind of come together in one, you know, thing. Politics and, you know, firearms. That happens a lot, and we can talk about that. But today we can talk about bicycles in the nanny state. So the ever-encroaching government or local governments, school districts, stuff like that, and students riding their bicycles to school. I am not a parent, so some of you parents can probably correct me on this, but states and schools across the country are basically banning kids from riding their bicycles. And basically what they're alluding to is that it's a safety issue, that, you know, kids are going out there and they're getting hit by cars, the parents are not paying attention when they're bringing their kids into school and they hit kids on their bicycles, so on and so forth. I have one example, and it's what I want to talk about. This is Atlantic City. This is Michigan. Students punished for riding bikes to school in Michigan. Okay, seems pretty straightforward. Okay, here's how it starts. The mayor was handing out donuts. There was a police escort, but a group of 64 high school seniors who rode their bikes to school in Kanawha Hills, Michigan, Tuesday, were sent home as punishment by an angry principal who denounced the ride as a dangerous prank. And then, let's see, this is the principal. Pennington said the ride put students in danger, tied up traffic, and prevented staff from getting to school. One senior recorded the principal on a cell phone as she laid into students for their actions. If you and your parents don't have sense enough to know, your brains could end up splattered on 3 Mile and Kinney, Fruit Ridge, and then maybe there. That's my responsibility. Pennington said, get your butts home. You're not participating in senior walk today. About 60 seniors got the day off and missed the traditional last walk through the halls of Kanawha Hills, though students say many more seniors received the one-day suspensions. Wow. Just to give you a little statistic that's in here that I think is pretty interesting. According to U.S. Department of Transportation surveys, in 2009, only 13% of all children walked or rode to school, whereas in 1968, nearly half, 48%, did. The remoteness of new schools is not the only cause. Among students who lived within 1 mile of 43 years ago, 83% walked or bicycle, while today only 38% do. So, we have an obesity epidemic, and you have Mayor Bloomberg and principals and schools all cracking down on the sugary drinks, yet they won't let the kids ride their bicycles to school. This is freaking crazy. I don't know what to say, because on one hand, I understand what the principal's doing, but when they say that it's her responsibility to basically prevent these kids from getting their brains ended up splattered on 3 Mile and Kinney or whatever it was, even though they had a police escort and the mayor had sanctioned the event, it is a complete overstepping of the school's bounds and what they should be doing as far as education versus nannying the children or basically becoming this larger than they're supposed to be involvement in the student's life. I would have loved it if I was 64 high school seniors rode their bikes. That's really cool. I would have loved it if I was a senior and that went down. Anyway, that's all it is. The link will be down in the description. Go check it out. And let me know, you parents, is this something that you guys are familiar with? The banning of kids riding their bikes to school. I got my hipster bike hat on for just this occasion, and yeah, take it easy, guys.